Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I have gotten a few new CoverGirl products and some old CoverGirl products, and then I've got some new bronzing and contouring stuff that I'm going to use. First, we're going to pull my hair back, and the light, I'm using natural light today, and we're getting ready to get a storm here, and it's just kind of going in and out. This is not the prettiest look in the world. But it'll work. I did a complete look on LA Girl, and it'll go up next week. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take the True Blend CoverGirl Skin Primer Combo Skin. And I have combo skin because I have dry patches here, and then I have some oily, and then I have just normal. But I'm going to take that, and it comes out pretty watery. It's got a little bit of a smell to it. I'll rub that all over my face. I've got some spots where I had some friends that popped up that I didn't want to be here. And I'm going to use the green concealer, which in my video, my LA Girl video, I used after I put my foundation on, when I should have used it under my foundation. So we're going to try it a little different. So I am going to go ahead and do my eyes, and I'm going to take some Scotch tape. And this is a little trick I've seen off of Tracy Helms' channel. You just take regular Scotch tape, Dollar Tree tape's fine, and you put it right there on your eyelid or your corner. And this will help you get a good, clean, crisp shape. So I've kind of changed my makeup routine a little bit. Instead of doing my face and then doing my eyes, I do my eyes, then my face. But I put my concealer on first, or my primer on first. So one of the new shades I've got is the CoverGirl True Naked Roses. It's in the rose pattern. The case is kind of cheap, flimsy plastic, which is CoverGirl, so I wouldn't expect any more. But the colors are gorgeous. I've swatched them, but I've not swatched them on camera. But there's a lot of mattes. There's one, two, three mattes, and one, two, three, four, five shimmers. So I'm going to go in with a Morphe 535, which is just a big fluffy brush. And I'm going to take this white shade here. It's called Almond. These actually have colors. This is called Almond. And I'm going to put that all over my lid. There is quite a bit of fallout. But like I said, it's CoverGirl. Even some of the high-end eyeshadows do this, though. So, but I'm going to take it all over my eyelid. And this is just going to give you a good base. I'm going to do it on both sides. Okay, and with the same brush in my crease, I'm going to go in with this purple color right here. Let's see, it's one, two, three, four, fifth one down. And it's called Copper Rose. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. Copper Rose. Don't look like Copper Rose to me. It's a purpley. Well, I mean, it looks like a rose color, but copper would be, to me, it would be like glitter. But there is quite a bit of fallout, as you can tell. And I'm going to put that in my crease. And I'm going to put more on the outer end than on the inner. These go on really smooth. They blend. They're very blendable. Just got a lot of kick up. But like I said, I've gotten some high-end products that do the same thing. So I ain't too worried about that. And make sure that you get it smoothed out really well. I put up a 5 or 6 minute video. It was a secondary remark to my, see how much fallout there is on my tape? To my WetN'Wild. And somebody said, I like your long ones better. I like the stories. I'm going to go to the shade next to it, which is called Dust. And I'm going to go below that with the same brush. And I'm going to focus that right on the outer of the eye, outer part of the eye. And then I'm going to drag it in just a little bit below. But most of it's going to be right here in the crease and then on the eyelid. But you know, every now and again, I like to do a short video. Something real simple. But everybody keeps telling me they like my stories, so let's see the story today. Smokey's gone, not for good. They're half a day tomorrow at school, and then they're out Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, and they go back on Tuesday for Easter. So Maddie had to have Smokey go home with her until Friday, and then she's staying here Friday. So I'm going to take, this fourth color in. It's called Rose Gold. It's got a lot of a pigment to it. And I'm going to take this on a M15 Morphe. And I'm going to put that right in the center of the eyelid. And I'm going to leave the inner part open. And I'm going to blend that in, and then I'm going to take that eye brush that I had, that 535, and I'm going to re-blend that in just a little bit. Let's take that rose gold again and put it on this side. I want it just in the centers where I'm focusing it at. Maddie came home from school today and came over to my house and stayed and ate dinner with us and stuff. And then Josh was in here putting office certificates on the hard drive. He was copying them onto the printer and putting them on the computer so he'd have a hard copy of all of his certificates that he's got for firefighting. So Maddie said, Smokey's going home with me. With a Morphe R42, it's just a flat panel brush. I'm going to dip into this second color here, which is called Champagne. And I'm going to put that on the inner part of my eyelid. And I'm going to blend it out towards the end or towards the middle. The darker colors seem to blend a little bit better than the lighter colors. And I'm going to take that 535 and just re-blend that crease just to make sure that I don't have any harsh lines right there. Okay, then I'm going to take a little flat eyeliner brush. This is the M432, and I'm going to take the fourth one in, which is the rose gold again, and just on the end of the brush, I'm going to go up underneath my eye on the bottom. And then I'm going to dip into that, what is that one called? Dust, which is the one we got on the corner. And put it on the corner on the bottom and just kind of smoke that out so it blends together. And I'm going to go up here and just put a little bit more in because it's a little bit, it could pack a little bit more where it's more of a dense brush. I'm going to pack just a little bit more. Now, the LA Girls got some good hits, and they got some good misses. You'll just have to watch the video. I'm going to go back in with that rose gold and get it underneath the rest of my eye. Lashes on the bottom. Even though I've done smoked them out. Take the dust back in and go back in with that. And again. Okay. Now, we got the eyes completely done except for mascara and eyeliner. We can go ahead and take this off. And as you can see, you've got the clean lines. You don't have to go in and do it. What I was saying is I'm going to use the green to offset to offset the redness from my rosacea or the redness from my nice little friends that popped up that's done gone. You squeeze this up and it's on a brush. It doesn't take much. My rosacea is the main thing I want to try to cover. And like I said, this is something different I'm trying. I don't know how it's going to work. This is just... I mean, there's no right or wrong way to put on makeup. It's a learning experience for all of us. I'm going to take a Ulta Beauty sponge. Kind of pop that green out. Blend that green. I'm going to use the tip of it to do that. The only reason I'm using the tip is because it's a little bit more pointy. If I get into the creases of the nose, it'll really work. The wind's kicking up high here, so I know that storm's getting closer. It's supposed to be in here by like 6. Well, it's 6:20 now, they ain't here, so. Okay. Now I'm going to take, this is one that's been out for a while. It's CoverGirl True Blend, and it is in the shade L1 Ivory. I wore this, I only wear this on special occasions. I wore this on our Vow Renewal. I love this foundation. It's one of my favorites. Well, the pump stuck. But to be honest, since I wore it, I mean, it's still good. I'm about out. I didn't think I was that close to being out, but I guess I am. Well, let's just open the bottle here and get some off the... We got a whole bunch there, so we'll just get off that for right now. Okay. That should be more than enough to do it. I'm going to take my finger and I'm going to put some on my face. Make sure that I put it right where that green is. And the wind's starting to kick up pretty good, guys. And it's all the storms. It's from the south and out west and all the tornadoes that's hit down south and stuff. We're getting the wind and the rain and stuff off of it. Then with my sponge, I'm going to start patting that in. But anyway, we had tacos. Maddie was hollering last night, Taco Wednesday. And when we were in school, which was 20 years ago, it was Taco Tuesday or Taco Thursday. Most of the time it was Taco Tuesday and Pizza Friday or Pizza Thursday. Now this foundation, I know you can still get. I like it. It's a little bit dewy. Luminous, dewy. which I really like. It's not completely full coverage. You can add to it and make it full coverage. You can mattify it by doing powder and mattifying it down if you want to mattify it. I'm going to do another layer just in my problem zones. Just build that up a little bit more. And it doesn't get cakey when you do this, is what I like about it. It's thin, but it's thick. If that makes sense. It's kind of an in-between type thing. But it really works. And if that stupid giraffe in New York don't have that baby soon, I get to watching her at night and thinking she's definitely going to have it, because that thing starts kicking the crap out of her and kicking the side, her sides. And it looks like her sides are literally going to explode. And I think, I'm going to fall asleep, and as soon as I fall asleep, she's going to have it. Get up the next morning, she still ain't had it. So she needs to hurry and have that baby. Okay, now we got that down, we're going to go in with concealer, regular concealer. And I'm using the CoverGirl Ready Set Gorgeous in Fair. And we're going to get these dark circles down by the nose. I don't know why I'm red like right in here. This used to happen when before I had my hysterectomy. And I was getting ready to have my menstrual or my period or however y'all. When I was growing up, you couldn't say that. You had to say monthly or stuff like that. You couldn't really. Well, in my family, it was that way. You didn't tell everything. But now, they just come right out and say, I'm having my menstrual cycle, or I'm having my period, or things like that. We're going to go back in with the sponge. Go ahead and pat that out. But I used to not get red at that time. And I didn't break out like that until then. Of course, where I had the polycystic, I would have the cramps, and I would have the bloating, and the irritability, and the cravings. I never had the period. I never had the bleeding. And that was because of all the cysts that I had. Which you can go and watch my real life story on polycystic. It's all in there, detailed. Get tissues ready. I've had people tell me that they've cried. I cried, so go ahead and have tissues ready. Okay, now we're going to set that. And I'm going to use the CoverGirl True Blend Blending Minerals in Light. Because with this, I don't have to worry about picking it up so I can't hear. It's got a sifter in it, and I'm going to sift some into the lid. And then I'm going to use the sponge. This is colored. And it says translucent. But it's got color to it, and translucent normally don't have color. We'll see. We're going to bake underneath the eye. Yeah, it's got color to it. I know it did. I mean, hello. But it says translucent. I don't know. We'll try it and see. One thing it does give me color. Or give me cake face. Now I'm not going to let it set. I'm going to go ahead and take a Morphe 412 and just go ahead and rub the rest of my powder out. Set all my primers and contours, concealers down. So I don't get cake face. Which I'm not going nowhere. I mean, I'm just doing the video. Because I need a video put up. And I haven't done one. I've done them, but I've not got them put up yet. So, now that we got that done, we are going to grab a wipe. Because I've got foundation and it's making me feel weird. Okay. Now we're going to go in and we're going to do some contouring. I've got the Too Faced Cocoa Contour Chisel Imperfection Kit. It's light to medium. It's beautiful. It's got light cocoa, medium cocoa, dark cocoa, and a pop of light. This is the light one. This is medium, this is dark, and then this is the pop of light. So we're going to do the light cocoa. And I'm going to go in with a small Luxie 512 contouring brush. And pick up that light cocoa and a little bit of the medium cocoa. And put them together. And put some bronzer on these cheeks. Take it and I'm gonna go across my forehead, kind of bronze up a little bit up there. I mix the same too. Get that temple. And then I'm gonna take, if I can find it, guys. Having to move all my brushes to find what I'm looking for. Ain't that awful? I'm going to take this Bayco U. It's a whole kit I got off of Amazon. And I'm going to take the medium cocoa on it. And I'm going to just kind of carve that out a little bit. And I'm going to take the same set of brushes and I'm going to take the littler one. Take that medium one and I'm going to go up and down my nose and contour my nose. And I'm going to take the same thing underneath my chin, underneath my bottom lip. This is just going to give it a little bit of dimension. Make it look like it's chiseled. Okay, and I'm not using the highlighter in this one. I'm going to use the highlighter in a different one. Now I am going to go in with a new blush I found. It is the Clean Glow blush and it's in 100 Roses. Looks like that. It's got three different shades. You can't really tell. I'm hoping it's buildable. We'll try and see. I don't have a backup plan for blush if it don't work. I'm going in with the Morphe 141. There's not a lot of pigment, so I'm going to go ham with it. Okay, then I'm going to do Cougar. This is something I got in a BoxyCharm a couple months back, maybe last year sometime. And it is in Diamond Kiss. This is Mineral Face and Body Shimmer. And I'm going to use my Real Techniques Sculpting Brush. And this is a powder. Since it is a powder, I'm going to dust a lot of it off because if not, you're going to have highlight from here to the moon, which some people like. I'm going to see from the temple around to the cheekbone, on the cheekbone. This is a yellow pigment. It's called Diamond Kiss. You'd think silver with it being Diamond Kiss. It's more yellow. Pop it on the edge of the nose. I'm going to pop it on my Cupid's bow. And then I'm going to go up underneath my eyelash and my eyebrow on the bone. And I'm raising my eyebrows up so I can do that. Put that on. And I'm used to closing stuff because if I knock it off, smoky, but with smoky not being here, I don't know why I'm doing it. I'm going to do my eyebrows next. This is the Easy Breezy Brow Shape and Define by CoverGirl. And I am in Soft Brown's what I got. Looks like mascara, but it's for your brow. I've never used this. This is the first time using it. And I don't like the wand. I'll tell you that right now. And I think Soft Brown's not soft brown at all. It looks dark to me. I'm going to get a Q-tip here. Clean up that little bit of mess I made. Go to the other brow. Do the same thing. Just come through. Okay. And then I'm going to go with my Morphe. R44 in this spoolie, and Lord, where'd that come from? Just kind of comb through this a little bit. It starts drying. Yeah, it looks a little bit better. So you can take some of the product off by doing this. If you do it with the product brush, you're going to put more product on. And it's not going to clean it up like you want to. I'm going to take the Ulta Clear Gel and go over top of it just so it'll lay. And they'll stay where I want them to stay. We had a tail on that one, Donna. Put a tail on this one. This is a little bit of a tail. This one ain't gonna get a big tail. This one got a pretty good tail. I'm gonna go in with CoverGirl Professional. Waterproof. It looks like this. It's a small caterpillar. It's in black. My eyes. And this I do. This is one I used to use a lot. It used to be very buildable. I don't know if it still is or not. I used to be able to build it pretty good. Okay, and then I'm going to hit underneath. Okay, one of the last things we're going to do is I'm going to use a CoverGirl. This is a, just says CoverGirl, and it's in the color All Natural. It's a pinky. It's a very pretty color. It looks like that. And I'm not used to lipsticks. I've been using liquid lips for so long that I about forgot how to do a lipstick. That's bad. That's pretty. Okay. And last but not least, we're going to take our Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray and spray this bad boy stuff down. Mmm, it smells so good. Take my hair down, which is still kind of wet because I washed it today. And if we were going out anywhere, I'd be ready to go except for clothes. That's the look. I hope you've enjoyed it. Day or night, wherever you are, be safe and be careful. If there's any kind of looks you want to see, comment in the comment bar subscribe. If you're not subscribed, hit that subscribe button. If you want to get notified when I'm putting up a new videos, which is on Tuesdays and Thursdays, hit the little bell beside of it. And I'll see you in my next tutorial. I love you guys. Bye.